Make sure it's focused. What's up, everybody? We're gonna do things a little bit different today. We're gonna answer some questions. He's gonna be asking me some questions that I'm gonna be answering. So we got like 45 questions here from you guys. So y'all tune in.
All right, so let's get into it. These are God's freaking bug.
I know.
All right, so we're gonna be asking my boy Eric Blinn some questions. These are the questions that you guys asked him in his Instagram.
In my Instagram story.
Follow the Instagram down below, right here. Click that right there.
Right there.
Yeah. So let's get into it. So, Mr. Eric Blinn's. All of these, I can't tell y'all who asked what because I mean, I'm reading off like a note sheet and it doesn't have your username. But first question is, is it okay to hit on a single mom at the barbershop?
What do you mean by that?
No.
Why not?
Two reasons, because it's not professional. And then another reason is she's probably just gonna use you to get free haircuts for her son.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I just realized that.
She's probably just gonna use you to get free haircuts and that's not cool.
Have you ever seen anyone do that?
No, I don't think so. But there's definitely like women that come in the shop and it's like, tch.
You're like, tch.
Yeah, but you gotta keep it professional. You can't like be like,
hey, let me get your number.
You can't say that.
Okay. Okay, we got that one out of the way. Number two, how do you deal with rude clients?
How do I deal with rude clients?
Have you ever like even had like a rude client?
Honestly,
I feel like all your clients are pretty dope, chill people.
Yeah, so like he records a lot of my clients, like the haircuts and stuff. All my clients are pretty trained, like I wouldn't say trained, but I trained them to be a certain way in my chair. So like I'm not gonna have people that are on their phone like this while they're getting a haircut just because of the roles that I go by in my business.
I'm getting hot.
It's hard enough,
yeah.
Wait, you took your mic off?
Yeah.
Wait, should I turn the AC on again?
No, we're chilling. It's just because this check is big, bro.
Okay. So pretty much, I don't really have rude clients. I'll have a little bit of picky clients, but they're not rude per se. Like, you can train them to be a certain way and they'll just follow your rules. Like, if they're rude to me, then there's like three strikes and third strike, they're out. I have to fire the client.
That leads me on to the next question. And I saw you post about this today on your story. How do you fire a client or how can you fire a client?
Okay, so.
I didn't even know that was possible.
Yeah, so like not every client is gonna be for you, I guess, right? Mm-hmm. And you have to learn how to discipline it because this is your business. Like people don't understand that like, you don't have to accept everybody that goes in your chair. So earlier today I had to fire a client. The reason why is because he booked two appointments previous, like in the past, and he would cancel last minute, and it's kind of like a waste of my time and his time. And like me, I'm a pretty valuable barber, and I can't be missing out on opportunities for other clients, or even if that like money, because I got to pay my bills and other stuff. So he booked it today earlier. Mm-hmm. And I was like, I'm sorry, like, unfortunately, like, I'm not gonna be able to like accept your, you know?
Yeah,
like,
cause you can accept and reject them.
On my booking app, this is why it's so important to have a booking app because you can look at the past history of your client. And I noticed two or three times that he canceled last minute. And then I just recognized the name. I've never even seen the guy because he never comes to the appointments. There's been three appointments in the past.
Have you ever like cut his hair?
I've never cut his hair. And I don't even have him on social media or nothing. So like that's the funny thing. I don't even know the guy and he kind of just wastes my time. So yeah, third strike and he's out. So I said, unfortunately, like more in the most professional way, like, hey man, sorry. Like I'm not going to be able to accept you as one of my clients. So that's pretty much it. Nice. He didn't text me back, but you win some, you lose some. There's more room out there for clientele.
That makes sense, bro.
There's thousands of people out there that need haircuts. So
yeah. it's like a never ending supply, you know, because everyone's gonna need a haircut, you know. So someone asked, how do you create content as a barber?
How I started out creating content was this right here, my phone. Literally, if you have a phone, you could create content. You're cutting hair. All you gotta do is just record it, take pictures, and then post it. Everybody is posting content nowadays. So all you gotta do is go on someone's profile and just copy what they just posted and just make it your own. So like, that's kind of what I do. I copy people and then they give me the idea of what to post next.
Oh yeah.
And so like, I noticed some people are doing Q&As. So like, I was like, might as well. And it'll also help you guys out. And just like put it out there, even if it's bad or good, like I know you might just be starting out content. So therefore you might not be as confident in your like craft of barbering, but just put it out there. I mean, you can go back all the way on the bottom of my page. My pictures, my haircuts, everything sucked. Like I used to get like 10 likes on my videos. It was as long as it was out there. And now 3 years later, it's, you know.
Yeah, they all hit now, bro. They're all pretty much everything's a hit. So that's what's up. Yeah. Bro, I remember I used to see it, bro. I used to be one of like the 12, 30 likes that he used to get on his post. Now I'm like one of the, like the 1,000 or whatever. So it's crazy, bro. It's wild.
Yeah, it's crazy. You just gotta trust the process. That's it. Bro. You gotta start somewhere. So
on to the next question. How do you save or manage your money as a barber? I know a lot of barbers probably need to hear this because not a lot of barbers, I mean, they probably make really good money, but they don't know how to budget and manage their, you know, their income.
Yeah. So like it's really hard, not gonna lie, but you wanna start a spreadsheet. And then manage your expenses and your monthly income or even your weekly income. What I tell everybody is I separate my regular income with my tip money. So any of the extra money that you're getting from tips, save that and then put it in a different account and then put your other money, that's your actual income, put that in your business account and then put the other money in your regular account. You don't even gotta spend it all, but it saves you a lot of money and it saves you a lot of budgeting, like a lot of stress. Because it's super hard. You get paid every day as a barber. You get
practically
paid.
Practically, bro. Yeah. You get paid every day.
And you just put that money in your pocket and you wanna go out to the club. You know, let's say it's Friday. It's a good day on the weekend. You wanna go out and spend all that money. Might not be the best.
Hey, you guys need to watch my boy, Graham Stephan. That guy, bro, if you watch him on YouTube, bro, he'll teach you like everything about finances. And like another guy, his name's, what's his name? Caleb Hammer. If he's, I doubt he watches this video, but if he watched this video, bro, hey, give me on your show financial audit. I'd probably be one of the only 20-year-olds that doesn't seem like a guy that's like in hundreds of thousands of dollars of debt.
Yeah.
That'd be pretty dope. But yeah, so what he said right there. Bro.
So yeah, just like, you don't gotta spend every dollar you make.
Just budget your money. I mean, that's all it really is. I mean, for my business and everything, I do like a lot of like, you know, camera work and, you know, other side jobs and everything. For the most part, I usually report everything on my spreadsheet. I mean, sometimes I get like a little cash here and there, and that's just cash. That's cash inflow, like, you know what I mean? Like, I just, you know, that's, if I have cash on me, I'll spend a little bit of it. But for the most part, you know, I budget it and I try to, you know, set a budget for each week.
Yeah.
So I don't like go crazy and spend money.
That's how it should be, you know? Start early if you can.
Yeah. I mean, start now, honestly. I don't even care if you're old or young.
It doesn't matter how much money you're making as long as you're setting a budget limit for the week.
Exactly.
Literally.
All right, next question. Was getting your barber license hard at all?
Yeah, getting my license was super, super hard because I was a COVID barber. Mm-hmm. So like...
No, yeah, I know a lot of people, and I, to this day, there's barbers that are really, really good, but they don't got a license, bro.
Yeah.
So I know it's a struggle for real.
It's super hard. There's like two major tests you got to take, and there's 1,000 hours you have to, you know, you have to get. And then once you get those hours, you get to take your tests, and you got to pass those tests with a high score. Not a lot of people can do that because the barber book, that's not on the test. It's like other stuff, like chemicals, sanitation, stuff that you don't even get taught. It's on the test. Mm-hmm. And then also, like, I was a COVID barber, so like my school at the time used to keep getting shut down. And then whenever it gets shut down, you know, I'm not learning nothing, I'm not doing nothing. It was just like, I was just sitting around, cutting hair, practicing. It took me 2.5 years to get my license. That's crazy.
How long do you think on average it takes a barber to get their license?
On average now,
yeah.
Like if it's like a really good school, probably like 8 to 12 months.
Yeah, because that's how Pablo said it took him like 8 months or something like that.
It can really take you like 8 to 12 months if you're locked in, you really want to learn, you really want to like get it done, then obviously your outcome, you know, you get what you put in basically. But if you're lazy, you're a procrastinator, you're not going to get your license. It's just professional if you get your license.
No, yeah, for sure. I mean, and not only that, I'm pretty sure like it helps regulate, you know, having people working in a shop.
Yeah.
Then, you know, you don't want, I mean, I'm pretty sure some barbershops don't care who's working in their shop as long as they're paying them.
Yeah, as long as they're
paying. But like I'm saying, like if it's a really, you know, well put together barbershop that really cares about their image and cares about, you know, everything that like professional wise that, you know, any business should, they're probably gonna want licensed people in there, not some guy that's gonna, you know, get kicked out and get everything shut
like
down.
Like, I have my license displayed by my station, which is pretty nice. Mm-hmm. It's like a little flex.
All right, now on to the next question. And we're actually in this place right now, but do you miss your studio?
Yes,
bro. This is like what? This is like, he's told me this is like his first time in 2 months that he's set foot in this building.
Guys, if y'all don't know, I recently moved into downtown Dallas into a shop with my boys, my good friends, and I miss, like, well, I haven't been in the shop, like you said, like in 2 months. And this is like my first time in here, and I literally just came in here a couple hours just to clean it up and get it set up. But I miss it, bro. Yeah, it was dusty. It still is. But I mean, the couch is
pretty nice. Right?
I've invested like a lot of money into it. It definitely, like, I was only in here for 8 months. And then I had an opportunity come to me, so I took it. I do miss it a lot. I do want to come back. But
so what would you do in this? Well, I mean, obviously you're not going to let it just sit here. What would you, do you think you should make this like a room, like a content room? Kind of like what we're doing right now.
Yeah, I would really.
Like, I'm going to show you guys a behind the scenes setup. I'll prop it up on the screen, but like from my phone. Yeah. But like, dude, this is a nice little like setup, bro.
It actually is. And like, we got good lighting in here, and the mural just, it just makes it look professional.
Bro. It looks cool. And like, bro, you can like, imagine you get like your own desk somewhere over there. And then you have to, it's like, it can be like a little chill spot too, you know what I mean?
And I could even cut hair still. I could do like after hour appointments.
Bro, he has
so
many clippers, he could definitely still cut hair here, bro.
I don't know, we'll see, maybe in the future. If you guys like this video, y'all want to see more of these videos or like a podcast, then I'll definitely do something with this shop.
Hey, let him know in the comments if he should start cutting hair on the side, or, you know, he'll probably have to charge extra, but like, hey, let him know in the comments, bro. Let him know.
I do miss it though, I'll tell you that.
Well, these two questions, they tie in together, so I'm gonna just put them together. Well, how far do you want to take your barbering career? And like, well, that ties into what was barbering, was going down a barber route worth it for you as well? Well, let's ask that first. Was barbering worth it for you?
Yeah, definitely. Like, barbering was definitely an invested career because you have to spend money to make some, right? This is definitely not a 9-to-5. You're your own boss, you're your own business owner. So you got to be prepared to work more hours than 9-to-5. And like the weekends, you know, a lot of people are mostly off the weekends. Your busiest days are the weekends. So
yeah, because everybody's trying to get that fade before you know, before they go out and stuff. Yeah. So,
I'd say it's worth it though. I really love it. The people that you meet and all that stuff, connections, networking, and just overall, like, barbering is such a good, it's a good industry and a good community. Uh-huh. Like, everybody just helps each other out now.
Well, that also ties into like, how far do you want to take this career? Now that you know that you love doing it and you say that it is worth it, how far do you want to go with it?
So eventually I want to like build like a barber school. Mm. Like, I want to stop cutting hair. Not like stop cutting hair. I want to keep my like day ones, like my OGs, like him, cut you guys, eventually in a barber school that I run. And then I want to have like students in there, you know, I want to have like, but I don't want to be cutting hair full time anymore. I eventually want to start up a brand like this hat, Society Blends. I'll stay tuned for that. But yeah, just like build up an audience and like start teaching, you know? Because there's more to it than just, you know, making your own money. I want to make an impact, not just money.
Sure.
That's
a good route, bro.
Yeah.
So what advice, I mean, you already, like, again, you touched upon all this pretty much, but like, another question was, what advice do you have for young barbers that, you know, that are just starting out? They don't even have to be young, people that are just starting out in general.
Yeah. So it's never too late to start barbering or cutting hair, really. And you don't even have to do it as a career. You could just do it just to cut your own hair, your friend's hair, your kids. I get a lot of DMs constantly, like, how do I start? You just have to get some Walmart clippers and just start cutting. There's really not much to it, just to do it yourself. You could be all talk but no action. But literally, you have to go through the motions of your own, you know, your hands and stuff. I'm not gonna hold your hand and like do it for you. That's what a lot of people think that school is. But nah, barber school, you gotta do it on your own. You gotta learn from your own mistakes. Trial and error will prepare you for like the future. But like I said, if you're doing it for a career, then that's a whole different story. You know, go to barber school and stuff. But if you're trying to do it just to do it for fun, side hustle, then just start cutting your own hair. If you don't have any clients, and start doing your own hair, or your dad, your brother, your cousin, all that stuff. They'll eventually like be down for you to cut their hair. So yeah, just start, pretty much.
And for these new barbers and everything, you know, I'm pretty sure you get asked this all the freaking time. Even like I get asked this, and I'm not a barber, but like for my own business, what's the fastest way to grow your clientele?
So social media, you have to post consistently. If you're on TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, anything, all platforms, post at least like 3 to 5 videos or pictures a day on any of those social media platforms. And I like promise you, you'll build clientele off of just posting your content and your portfolios, because people will actually, number one, they have to actually know that you actually cut hair, right?
Yeah.
And then number two, that's whenever the quality comes into hand. Like, hey, this guy's actually pretty good. Number three, your price. They'll be charging $20 when you just started. That's not ideal. You know what I'm saying? You have to charge. I started for like 8 months for like $0, I think. Dude, I would do like free house calls.
That's all wild, the time. Bro.
Yeah. But yeah, just do that. Just post content and try to tag your clients. So that way they can repost your story or whatever, and that way their friends see your work on their head.
No,
and then it's just boom, networking.
For sure. Now, like what he said, like, I mean, again, I'm not a barber or anything, but I feel like our industries go hand in hand pretty much. And like I would say, everything when you're starting out brand new, when you're a baby, like baby, like, you know, you just started, whether it's you just got your first camera or you got your first set of clippers, do it for free. I'm not saying no one, but I mean, a lot of people are not gonna say no to free work or free anything.
Yeah.
Cause you know, I mean, you're not gonna be that good starting out, like he said. You're not gonna be, you know, first month or first week cutting hair, charging people $20, mm-hmm. and vice versa for like a photo shoot or video shoot. You're not gonna be charging these people $100, $200 for like a photo shoot, or you're not gonna be charging the $500 for like a simple video, you know what I mean?
Yeah, exactly.
So do work for free, and you know, until you're confident enough and then everything, obviously you'll be able to charge people. But I, like he said, the fastest way to grow your clientele, post. I mean, I can't stress it enough. Like, you don't know what can blow up on anything nowadays.
Until you post it.
Like my favorite story is like, dude, I made my first ever soccer video with my old high school. And one of the clips that I got, it went viral on TikTok, got like, I don't know how many views, got a couple hundred thousand views.
It just got out there.
And it was like the first video I ever posted that was related to soccer on my TikTok. So you know what I'm saying? Like, you don't know. And after that, I mean, the rest is history. So like I was saying, you don't know what could hit. So like I keep saying, keep posting, don't stop posting.
Yeah. And sacrifice the money in the beginning. It'll eventually come.
Yeah, it's an investment, you know?
Yeah, like, you gotta trust the process.
I know we've been talking about a little bit like on the finance side of things and everything, and you know, it's probably one of the most important things on this planet. Is money the most important part of being a barber? If not, what is?
No. So if you don't know me like as a person, I pretty much don't care about the profits of my business. Not that I don't care, it's just, yeah, I don't see money as a big deal, because in the end, I mean, I'm still making a decent money. More than like a fast food restaurant, or like, mm-hmm. let's say if I was doing another job at like, I don't know, a car wash or something. It's just better that I'm already doing what I'm doing now, and I'm only charging $35. That's like pretty average for a barber for a haircut. And I could easily charge like 60, but I'm not gonna do that. I'm more for the people. I kind of like, what is it? It's called passion over profit. So if you love doing it, I feel like the money doesn't really matter in the end. I just like talking to people and like getting to connect and build a relationship with the client majority of the times. I give out a lot of free haircuts. I'm not gonna lie, remember that?
Yeah, like last we went year to Kansas, dude. This guy, dude, do we have a video? I think we have a video of like,
yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna pop up a video right here. Like, dude, this guy had like people in line at someone's like dorm or whatever in Kansas.
Yeah.
Just, I mean, there was so many kids that were just getting free haircuts from him. So like, yeah, he doesn't care that. I mean, I've seen it firsthand. He doesn't really care about making money off a haircut.
I did last year, whoever left a review on my booking app, I gave all y'all free haircuts. There was 25 people out of 300 clients that I had on my booking app at the time, and only 25 people left a review. They actually listened to me. So I rewarded those 25 clients with free haircuts. Mm-hmm. So that's a lot, bro. Like, people don't understand, but that's true. Like, a lot of people can do that. So.
All right, now time, you know, we've been talking about barbering. cutting hair. So now the questions were, you know, it's about cutting hair. So let's see how good you are at cutting hair. Okay, so.
Not very good.
First question is a taper or a fade easiest for you? I'm guessing he means like mid, low, you know, all those other fades and then a taper fade.
Like which one's easier for me?
Yeah, a taper or like any of the other fades, like the mid, you know, all the other stuff.
I'd say a fade is more easier for me because in the beginning I always had trouble with the tapers. Like I would always push them up super high. But with the fade, it's kind of hard to push it up because you're working with the whole canvas, right? You're working with the whole head shape, but the taper, you're conserving a lot of bulk on the sides and you're just dealing with the temple and the nape area. So I'd say a fade is more easier. Taper is more complicated, even to me to this day.
Damn. Yeah. I heard a lot of people say that, you know. Yeah. Tapers are pretty easy, so.
Not for me. Hey, I'm different.
All right, well, that kind of ties into the other question. What is the hardest haircut you ever done?
Bro, so like back whenever I worked in my grandpa's barbershop, there's a guy that came in and he wanted a mid-fade, right? Uh-huh. Like a mid-fade, and it was straight. Like he wanted like a military cut. Like it's not like a modern mid-fade where you drop it in the back. By just, the occipital bone, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, no.
So you got like a straight mid fade, and then he had a special request. He told me, he said, I have a special request though. Can you give me two lines symmetrical like this? And I was like, what do you mean by that? Like, so if you guys know, like if you're doing a comb over and you put a part on it, that's what he wanted, but on both sides. And it was weird. That was probably one of the hardest haircuts I've ever done. Because like,
bro, like just normal lines, like, or like, you know how people be getting like an arch or whatever?
Like, you know Mason?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, you know Mason. Duh. You know he has a hard part, right?
Yeah.
He wanted like another one on both sides.
He wanted two hard parts.
He wanted basically like two hard parts.
What?
It was weird, bro. Yeah, I tell you, that was the hardest cut ever because I couldn't get it. Like, what do you want? Like, what is the outcome out of this haircut? He's like, I just want to be different.
Bro.
Bro. I was sweating during that haircut because I couldn't get it right. Lines were all crooked and stuff. That was about a year ago.
That's wild. All right. Another question. Don't know who asked it, but how do you blend between no guard guideline and the one guard guideline?
How do you blend between the no guard and the one guard?
Yeah.
You're going to use your half guard. So a lot of people don't even use the half guard. They try to like skip the guards. If you can skip the guards, That comes with more experience of you cutting hair. I could see you doing that maybe 4 or 5 years into cutting hair. But if you're just starting out and you're trying to blend and you're trying to like...
Well, can you do that?
I could, but I don't like it.
Oh, like it won't come out that great.
Yeah, it doesn't come out that consistent in my opinion. But like you would have to use your half guard, you know, the 0.5 and just flick up into it and play with your lever. Just do a lever play into the one. But you're going to have to like mess with it yourself, zero gap your clippers and detail the fade. You know, everybody can go through the motions of cutting and just blend, but then can you detail? Detail brings out the conservative, what's it called? Detailing brings out like-
I'm not a barber.
It just brings out that blur effect, if that makes any sense. Mm. But yeah, just use your half guard, just I don't know, there's not much to it.
I was like, what was that?
The fridge. Oh.
All right, so somebody asked, what is your pet peeves while cutting hair? Or just, what's your biggest pet peeve while you cut hair?
My biggest pet peeve, when they move their own chair with their foot.
People do that?
Yeah, like I have super tall. You guys, if you guys are watching this, like my clients, you guys are super tall. Like I have a lot of tall clients, bro. And so like I'll pump up the chair all the way and they'll still move it with their foot.
How?
I don't know.
Like what makes you want to do that, bro? When I'm getting a haircut, I like to just like lay back.
Right.
And like, just like prop my feet up and like almost fall asleep. Yeah, like, what makes like, you like want to like...
He just kind of like, they kind of just look back in the mirror. Oh, I hate that.
I mean, I sometimes do that. You do that. I do that just because like I like to look at myself. I'm not going to lie.
This guy loves himself. That's
so funny. But it's not because I'm scared that he's messing me up or nothing. I just like to... Just look at the process, look at the progress.
That's probably it. Like when people look back in the mirror.
You feel like they're like judging your work?
Yeah, I feel like they're judging my work and like they don't trust me or they're like, it makes me feel insecure about the work that I'm doing to them.
No, I just do it because I think I look good.
Yeah, that's what
that's
a lot
the
of
only reason
say,
why I do that. I'm like, dang, I look
bro,
good.
Bro, when my clients good. Do that, I'm like, bro, can you please stop? He's like, bro, I just really like seeing it. Like, okay. That's probably it. Chewing gum.
Chewing gum. Does that not mess up when you're chewing gum and like, you know, cause like they're, since their jaw's like moving, does this not like mess it up?
Or it depends on how hard they chew their gum. But like chewing gum isn't really a big problem for me, but for some people, you gotta spit it out for them. But for me, it's not a big problem if you're chewing gum. Especially if your breath stinky. Yeah, you better keep that gum.
What about people when they get on the phone? Have you ever had that before where like they're constantly
yeah,
like,
your dad. Your, bro.
But like he be putting on speaker, I bet, no? Or does he actually
put actually he does.
Yeah, cause like, I'm pretty sure he doesn't want you to mess him up, obviously.
Yeah.
But like the people actually like, hello?
Yeah, some people do. Nah, it depends on the client. Like if it's a, like, let's say if it's like a business owner, you know, if he's like, you know, he has like to make phone, a call. I just stop cutting. Yeah. And I just let him talk, you know, take your time. No. But not really a big issue.
All right, this is probably the hardest question. What's the difference between a high and a low fade?
What's the difference between a high and a low fade?
Yeah.
Okay, so like a high fade is gonna be up here, military cut, and then a low fade is gonna be down here.
It's pretty self-explanatory.
It's pretty self-explanatory.
I'm not even a barber, but I know.
If you want me to go more in depth, a high fade is like on your parietal ridge, and then a low fade, you're keeping as much bulk right here. Not really, but you're just keeping bulk on the sides of your parietal ridge, and you're just keeping your C cups and all that stuff and just as low as possible.
Hmm.
That's it. But it is self-explanatory.
Okay. Someone asked, this is like about clippers. Rebels, Gamma Boosted, and Instincts. Wait, what? Hold on.
Oh, I remember typing
Rebels, this. Gamma Boosted, and Instincts. Which one would you get? Is that like three different clippers?
Yeah, yeah. Like the ones that I...
Okay,
that
so I yeah. Okay, so out of those three, out of the Rebels, the Gamma Boosted, and the Instincts, which one would you get? I guess this is some guy that's, they can't decide what clipper you
yeah.
want.
Yeah. So I've never used the Boosteds. I love the Instincts, so I'm gonna have to go with the Instincts. But I have used the Rebels. I like the Rebels, but they're just too light. Like they feel cheap.
Have them back here anywhere? No.
No, I don't have them back here. They're in the other shop. But yeah, I'd probably go with the Instincts. They're all good clippers. Stylecraft, top tier clippers.
All right. Well, this is a pretty good question. What do you do about clients that don't tip?
Well,
I'm pretty sure you get people that don't tip.
Yeah. So me personally, I don't really care. But I do know that some people do really care. Mm-hmm. Or like I've had some clients come to me and they're like, how much? I'm like 35. They're like, plus tip or without? I'm like, what do you mean? I'm like, bro, you don't have to tip me. Like, it's just give me 35 or just give me more if you want. But
like the minimum.
35. I'm not going to trip if you give me the minimum, the bare minimum, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But,
well, I think some people trip because like, you know, some people like, how do you say it? Like, don't they have to like pay like commission or something? Or like the shop takes a percentage of whatever they make. So like, let's say if someone charges like $50 and the shop takes like 30 of it, they only keep 20. I'm pretty sure they're going to be like, bro, like, give me a little 5 or 10, yeah. You know, because the shop's taking like 30, 40% of my money, 60%.
It just depends on your situation.
Yeah, I'm pretty
sure. I would never like go with commission unless you're just starting out at the shop or as a barber, period. But if you have your clients pretty, you know, if you're pretty booked up, then go on booth rent because commission is just gonna steal your money. But if you're trying to build up your clientele, then definitely go commission rate. You're gonna have to sacrifice that money in the beginning. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, I could definitely understand that.
Next question.
I don't really trip.
I mean, you already answered this, but how much do you charge currently? You charge $35.
Yeah, I charge $35 for everything.
Someone asked, how do I book an appointment?
How do you book an appointment? I have a booking link in my Instagram bio. Just go to my link tree, and then I have all my links there to any of my socials or my booking link. I do not cut kids, so just saying.
I do not cut kids.
Dang. So. Yeah, might be like someone's mom or something. You know what I'm saying?
How did you make money when you're inexperienced with cutting hair?
I didn't really. The
you
only
make money.
Yeah, you didn't make money in the beginning. Like, trust me. Like, the only money I made was like a couple bucks, and it was
like,
off of tips.
Yeah, I was about to say someone would be like, oh, since you cut my hair, it goes $20, bro, just cause. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They're just good people out there, you know.
So. Yeah, of course. Like, whenever I was in barber school, I'd just get like 5 or 7 bucks tips. Mm-hmm. And then I'd get the money and go eat.
You can go out to that Wingstop or something down the street.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Someone asked, what Clippers did you start out with?
I think they're not up here, actually. No, I did have those in the beginning, like within my first year. Mm-hmm. So I actually started out with their walls. I had the wall designers, they're cordless. They're kind of like the Magic Clips, but cheaper. So I started out with those. They could not be zero gap, so it was super hard for me to cut hair with those and blend out the lines. And then my trimmer was an Andes Slimline Pro Li. If you guys know, those trimmers are like super small. And then the foil shaver, I had a wall Finale. I think I had a wall Finale foil shaver.
I don't know what that is.
But yeah, that's it. It was a cheap setup, but it was cool. It got the job done, definitely paid off, you know?
Yeah, definitely. How long have you been cutting hair for, someone asked?
I've been cutting hair for 3 years. I've been licensed for 1.5 years, and I've been in barber school for 2.5 years. That's how I answer whenever someone asks me, because it sounds more professional. Mm. You just say 3 years, like, dang. So I'm like, I've been licensed. I was in barber school for 2.5 years. I've been licensed for 1.5 years. I've been cutting in total 3 years. Mm. Right? Yeah.
Someone asked, what camera do you use?
So it depends. Like, if I want to make a quick clip or a quick video, I make it with this. It's an iPhone 14. But if I want to make something more depth or like something like this, like we're using his camera right now. It's a Sony A7
IV. We're using a Sony A7 IV right now. But like usually if he's gonna use like take pictures or like do his own thing with his own camera, it's a Sony A7 III.
A Sony A7 III.
Yeah.
With a Sigma 2.8 70 millimeter lens.
28 to 70.
Oh,
that's the same lens we're shooting on right now.
For real?
Yeah. Oh. Well, yeah, we have the same lens.
There you
but
go.
Definitely
do some YouTube research on the camera before you use it.
Yeah, do your homework over these cameras, because
I'm still kind of getting used to the camera.
Getting used to my camera.
I have to ask this guy for tips, but he never responds.
How much did you pay for barber school?
So like this was back in COVID days.
I know people be paying like anywhere from like
10 to 12.
Yeah, like 10 bands. 12 bands,
people,
15 maybe.
In 2023, people are paying like 10 to 15K on barber school. Back whenever I was doing it, I was in high school, right? Uh-huh. So I had a high school tuition for barber school, so it was only $4,000. But
that sounds like a steal to a lot of people.
Yeah, shout out to my parents. They're the ones that really helped me with that. I couldn't even pay it, bro. I was broke. But they helped me pay it.
That's good.
So yeah, shout out to my parents, they're supporters.
But like, what do you think is a good price point nowadays? Or like, because I know Marcos, he's in school. I don't know, I never asked him how much he's paying, but like.
I don't know how much he's paying. A lot of people ask me like what school to go to. I don't know. I mean, I can't tell you. I don't want you to mark my word for it. I don't know what's out there. But I think like a 6 to 10 thousand is a good price. I mean, I don't want to be the one to compare, but if you're going to college, you're paying like well over 30K, depending on where you're going. I mean.
Can you take financial aid? Do they have financial aid for barber school?
Yeah, okay. You can definitely get help from barber school.
There is, because I remember I signed up for my FAFSA for like my school this past year, and I saw like I just put Dallas in it, and as soon as I put Dallas, there was like barber schools in there.
Really?
That you could get for your FAFSA will send you money for it.
Huh. Yeah, you could also talk to like the barber school owner, and you know you could work with them a lot.
Get a scholarship.
Nah, but like they'll like tell you how much monthly and stuff and your down payment. But mine was $4,000, luckily.
Someone asked, what app do you use to edit your videos?
Believe it or not, they're free apps. Like I don't spend money on my editing softwares yet because I don't feel like I'm there yet. But I just use iMovie, and then after that, I export it to my iPhone. Or is that what's called, export?
Yeah.
I don't know. I just send it to my iPhone, AirDrop it, and then I put it into CapCut, and then I add captions through there because CapCut has auto captions and it's super easy to make, super reliable, convenient.
And it's so free.
It's free. Like
it's free. CapCut is free. It's a really good app. I mean, I can't recommend CapCut enough. There might be some stuff that you might want to do on there. It might cost money. I don't know. I just know my version is free.
The stuff that's already on there that's free, you can definitely make content, the content that I'm making right now. Anybody can do it.
Anybody can make content. Like I tell the people that all the time, anyone can make content, whether it's on So I mean, if you want to use an actual software, DaVinci Resolve is a great, amazing tool that's free. Yeah. I personally never used it, but I have some homies that did use it, and some of them still use it to this day, but they use like the paid version. But again, they started off with the free one. It was great. I personally use Adobe Premiere Pro and After Effects. Depends on what I'm doing or what project I'm working on. I usually use Premiere Pro for everything, whether it's, you know, YouTube videos, Instagram Reels, TikToks, like anything that I want, I do it on Premiere Pro. And then if I want to do like some crazy visual effects or crazy little, you know, stuff on my videos, I use After Effects, and that's, you know, that's, I have something that's like called Adobe Creative Cloud, and it lets me have anything that's Adobe product or Adobe software, not free, but for like a monthly subscription for like $30 a month.
That's like more invested though, right? It's like when you're higher in the game, you kind of like, you built up your consistency already enough to want to pay for a software.
Yeah, right? Not only that, and like you're, you know, you're pretty much, I'm not gonna say you're fully in, because I know people that have these softwares and they're not fully in.
Yeah.
But like you pretty much, you get it because you wanna learn more, and you already have a better understanding, and you wanna, you know, create better quality things.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Yeah.
You just CapCut basically. That's the
CapCut and iMovie.
Ooh, this is a good question right here, bro. How can I become an ambassador for Barber products?
Oh, that's a good question.
Cause you recently became an ambassador for a few products. Huh?
Yeah, so like a couple products just hit me up out of nowhere. So as soon as I started like one ambassadorship, then all of them started coming. So I'm an ambassador for the Barber Plug. If you guys don't know, this is him on Instagram right here. Shout out the Barber Plug. And then I also am an ambassador for Stylecraft, you know, the Clipper brand, which is right here. So I got these, I'm sponsored by them. And then the Blessed Kicks, I am an ambassador for them too. So if you use my code, you get money off. And then a Cranium Styling Company, they're like styling products. I also sponsor them too. So what is that for? Mm-hmm. And how I got that is because you just like post. You post them, you tag them, you wanna make them look at like your page. You kind of want to bug them and like shoot your shot. And if they get back to you, they get back to you. And if not, then they don't. But majority of the times, you just want to show how consistent you are on creating content. And then when you're consistent and you're getting like good, I don't want to say like views, I want to call it engagement. So when you're getting good engagement and you're getting good supporters from your videos, then it shows that like you're worthy enough to be an ambassador for the company that comes out to you.
Yeah, because anyone can like get views, but like, it's like being consistent. How consistent can you be getting that engagement on your content pretty much?
So what the Barber Plug told me was, he's like, bro, like I love you to be an ambassador for my company because I see that you make videos every day. So literally just make videos every day, post what you're using, the clippers. It could be anything, you know, shout out Stylecraft, shout out Babyliss, anything. Babyliss would be a huge one for me because that's like one of the biggest brands out there right now. But literally just like post your work and your content and be consistent and show people what you do best, and then they'll probably reach out to you. But just build an engagement, community base. That's it. Mm. I'm done.
He's not done. I'm just responding back to some people real quick. Important. Okay, anyways, back to the Q&A. How long did it take to build a steady clientele? I mean, 3 years.
Yeah.
Pretty much 3 years.
I mean, 3 years, because I'm finally being like pretty booked up. And so, yeah. But I mean, being booked up for me is like 8 to 13 cuts a day. So working 5-6 days a week, 5 days a week, actually. Mm-hmm. But it takes a while, guys. You got to understand that like, it's not just going to come, you know, easy. It's not going to come the next day. You know, you're not going to have these wave of clients. And it's also kind of like a seasonal thing. Because let's say like recently I just did haircuts for the high school, the prom. So I was super booked. I think I did like 62 haircuts in that week. So that's a lot. So I definitely did squeeze-ins. I worked from 7 a.m. to around 8, maybe 9 sometimes. But I mean, to build clientele, you gotta be in the shop 6-7 days a week, you know, open to close. You gotta understand, being there is what's more important. Mm. That's how you build clientele.
So somebody asked, and this is a really good question too. I don't know if you ever ran into this problem, but this guy did. Side hustles you can do from the shop when not busy, or side hustles that, you know, barbers can do. I feel like that ties into anyone though, I mean, not just barbers.
Yeah, so I mean, you could just do anything really. There's so much, I don't even want to say it like that, but there's so much money to be made out here that you can literally do anything. I was talking to my sister about this. You can literally come out with, like, I'm literally coming out with these hats, and I'm gonna come out with a website. You can come out with, you know, your own merch, or I don't know. I mean, you could do photography like this guy.
Yeah.
It's just whatever you feel like, what's in your niche, like whatever you feel like you like doing, just do it. And you can make money off of it. And apparently there's a good amount of people that are making more money off of their side hustles than their actual job. That's how you know you're making it.
Nah, yeah, and like my two cents on that was like, there's so many different side hustles, bro. I mean, yeah, I mean, like you said, there's so many different ways to make money. I mean, again, you could pick up a trade, you could pick up a skill, get good at it, and then start monetizing it, whether it be, you know, barbering, nail tech people, lash tech people, you know, skin care, photography, videography, video editing, photo editing, you name it, man. There's so many different little, you know, in that kind of niches, kind of, you know, side hustles. But then you have the other people, you know, that, you know, they cut lawns for like on their, they do lawn
services,
services on the side, you know, they do plumbing, they do electric, they do pretty much anything, bro. Like anything can be monetized. And again, you can DoorDash, you can do Grub, is that a thing?
Grubhub.
Uber Eats, you can be an Uber driver, Lyft driver. Dude, there's so many things you
can do. It doesn't matter what it is, as long as you're bringing a different source of income in and you like doing it. Like,
I know a guy that literally makes a living off just doing Uber Eats, DoorDash, and Uber, and all these other little, you know, what are they called? I don't know, those little apps where, you know, that you provide a service with your own vehicle.
Yeah, it's like a convenience.
And he makes a living out of that. So like, again, there's a billion ways to make money out here. So it's all up to you if you want to, you know, actually put the effort into either learn or, you know, do it. So there's so many different side hustles you can do, bro, that, you know, if being a barber is not generating enough money, dude, there's different side hustles that you can do, bro, 100%.
Yeah. It all ties down to like, how much do you want it?
Collab with Miggy Cuts.
Oh yeah. I texted him, but he never texted me back.
I don't know who Miggy Cuts is. Who's Miggy Cuts?
Miggy Cuts is a barber that we're kind of like making like this same style content.
Are y'all mutuals? Know? Y'all follow each other?
Yeah, we follow each other on Instagram. I've never met him before, but he seems like a pretty chill dude. I think he's in Oklahoma.
Mm.
He's either based in Oklahoma or Tennessee. Yeah, he's pretty cool, bro. Like, we had the same, like, kind of, like...
Like, the same personality?
Yeah,
the same kind of content? Or
the same content, personality, I guess, quality-wise. We're just, like, pretty outgoing. And, like, I want to meet this guy. But I asked him, or he said that. He said, you want to do a collab? I'm like, shoot, I'm down. He never texts me back. All right. Well.
What about a collab with George?
A collab with George Fates? I'm down. I need to text him.
Yeah, we're supposed to go on a Houston trip. If you're watching this, George, I'm still waiting.
Yeah,
we're still waiting.
We're waiting, bro. Waiting for that text message.
You've taken so long that I'm already going on my own Houston trip with someone else. This is this is the craziest question.
What is it?
What car do you drive?
Bro.
I don't know.
I don't know who asked me this.
I'm dead, bro.
I drive a Honda. Here's my car keys right here. It's a Honda. I have two cars, but I daily drive my Honda and have a truck, like a lowrider. Yeah, just a going out car and then a daily car. Let's see. I don't know why you asked me what kind of car do I drive.
Hey man, he just wants to know what car you're driving. All right, this is the final question. If it wasn't for blank, I would not be cutting hair.
Probably my grandfather. Do you know that? He knows my grandpa. My grandpa is a barber. He's pretty much the one that like got me into it, because I saw like, I didn't see like how wealthy he was, but I saw that he like had so many connections and like so many relationships. Everybody knew my grandfather, because like back whenever he was younger, he used to cut hair in downtown Dallas.
Dang.
Like right next to where I cut right now.
For real?
Yeah, and then he got too busy, so he moved his shop, you know, into Kaufman.
Mm-hmm.
But I think because of my grandpa and then also COVID, If COVID wasn't here, bro, I probably wouldn't even be. We probably wouldn't even be here right now. I probably couldn't even say, man. But yeah. COVID definitely like blasted my business. Like it exposed my business because every shop was closed. But yeah, right. I like it.
That's all the questions, man.
That's all the questions.
Shut the computer. That's all the questions. All the questions you've asked. Not all of them, but that's a good amount.
That's a good amount of questions.
That was a lot
I didn't
of questions.
Put all of them in there, but if you guys want me to answer more questions, just drop a comment down below your question. And then we'll try to make another video like this for you guys.
Oh yeah. Anything else you want to say to them?
Thanks for being here.
Not me then.
This is like a last minute video.
Oh yeah, it was.
It's what, 10 o'clock? It's 10:30 at night. We're recording
this. It's 10:30 right now.
But this is a good like
setup, bro. Like it's this nice. Is something that he could honestly put together, whether it be like a little podcast, Q&A or anything, you know, serious to sit down and talk about stuff. So
I want to like bring other barbers in here.
Bro, and imagine then, like, that.
Interview them. Like I already know I got one guy that I want to interview really bad. His name is F2 Fades. You remember him?
Oh yeah.
He's in Mesquite.
Bro, that guy, he was at the West Mesquite game and I took a picture of him. I didn't even know it. The crowd. I still need to send him the photo. I never did.
He didn't call me. He texted me. He's like, bro, are you at the game?
I remember that. Yeah, he texted you if you were at the game.
Yeah, he texted me if we were at the game. I was with him shooting a soccer game and he was just in the stands. But yeah, F2 Faze, if you're watching this video, I want to interview you right here. Bro, he's probably like the youngest hustler that's like super consistent with cutting hair. Bro,
and post stuff.
He posts a lot. Bro, he definitely has potential of like, I mean, anything, bro. Like he has a potential of like being up there with the big dogs.
We should get George on here, bro.
George Fades?
Yeah.
Hey, George. If y'all want George Fades, tag him in the comments.
I know you're watching this, George. I'm going to text you right now.
You liked my story earlier, George.
He commented on my post earlier today.
Bro? Oh, yeah, he did mine too on TikTok.
He commented on my post. He commented on my Instagram reel.
Huh.
You're watching this, George. I know you are, so you're going to be here one day.
You want to wrap it up or what?
No, yeah, I mean, that's about it. I mean, again, it was something a little different. Probably going to make a lot of Instagram reels and TikToks out of this little, not little, it's pretty long video so far.
Yeah.
But, you know, I mean.
Just let us know if y'all want more of these. I liked it because, like, this can actually, like, help a lot of you guys out, whether it be answering your questions or just entertainment. But for the most part, I did this so that way I can help you guys out as much as I can. Because I can't always answer your questions on DMs, on Instagram. Like, there's just so many, and I can't get to them. So this right here helped out. So let me know in the comments if you guys enjoyed. And we're out of here, I guess.
Peace.
See you later.